Last year, I began my journey into the wonderful hobby of beekeeping, and I had a really good time. I learned a lot, and I got to see some really cool bee activity. Unfortunately, my colony did not survive the winter, and so I'll have to start again this spring with new bees. I believe the issue primarily was that I didn't have enough bees going into winter. On the bright side, however, I'll be starting from a better spot since I already have drawn out frames of wax, and I'm hoping this will give me the edge to get my bees through the winter this season. Additionally, I'll be doing some things differently this year, starting with the installation of my bees. You see, when purchasing bees, there are two primary forms you buy them in. One is a package of bees, which is a box containing roughly 10,000 bees, and a queen bee. And that's what I started with last year. To install a package, you simply shake the bees into a hive, add a queen, and that's it. The second way in which people typically get their bees is called a nucleus, or a NUC for short. A NUC is actually a small hive itself. It comes typically with 5 drawn-out frames, including honey, pollen, nectar, and brood, as well as significantly more bees than a package, and an already established queen. It's usually a tad more expensive than a package, but it's well worth it if you're looking to jumpstart your new colony. This year, I'll be starting with a NUC of bees instead of a package, and here it is. As you can see, this NUC is jam-packed with bees, and I'm hoping that it will help me get to a large colony by the end of the season, so that I'll have enough bees to make it through winter. To install this nucleus, I'll first start by opening up the hive and inspecting each frame. Since the NUC comes with 5 frames already, I'll need to remove 5 frames from my hive to make room, and I want to keep the frames with the most wax on them to further help this colony take off. So, I'll quickly examine each existing frame and keep the very best ones. After that, I'll make room in the center of the hive to place the NUC frames. It's best to keep the NUC frames together without splitting them up so that the bees can keep their brood warm while the hive is still relatively small. Next, it's time to crack open the NUC, and I'll just take a moment to mentally prepare myself as I want to act decisively once the bees are flying around. So, after a moment to collect my thoughts, I pry the top of the NUC off, and here's what it looks like. As you can see, there are a lot of bees on the lid, and I quickly scan for the queen. I don't see her there, so I go ahead and knock all of the bees into the hive. You can see that there's a bit of burr comb on the lid, but that's nothing to worry about. So, next, I'll begin by pulling the frames out of the NUC. Since it's a fairly warm day, I can also inspect each frame without worrying about hurting the developing brood, and I want to get a baseline of where the colony is at and potentially even find the queen. Looking at this frame, it's pretty heavy, and it's mostly capped honey and nectar. I quickly look for the queen, but I don't see her, so I go ahead and place the frame in the hive. It's generally a good idea to keep the frames in the same order and orientation that they were in the NUC, so I make sure to place this frame on the end. Next, I'll take out the second frame from the NUC and proceed in the same fashion. On this frame, I see a mixture of capped over brood, as well as some open nectar, and even some capped honey. Again, I quickly scan for the queen, but I don't find her. So I'll place this frame in the hive as well. At this point, I should note that I'm not using any smoke for this installation. Normally, you would use smoke when inspecting a hive because it can calm the bees down. However, the reason that smoke works is that it prevents the bees from communicating by pheromone. You can think of it like jamming their radio signal. That being said, when installing a nucleus like this, you don't want to use smoke much if possible, because the bees will actually produce a pheromone which signals the other bees to group into the new hive. If I use smoke, it could interrupt this process and take longer for the new colony to establish. Anyways, I'll move right along to the third frame. This is the center frame of the NUC, and I see some uncapped brood. Again, I quickly look for the queen, as this is the most likely frame for her to be on. However, after a minute, I don't find her, so I'll go ahead and add this frame to the hive as well. It's not critical that I find the queen at this stage, and mostly I'm just keeping an eye out for curiosity. Since there's brood in the nuc, it's a good bet that there's a queen too. Moving right along to the fourth frame, I see some more capped brood, as well as some nectar and pollen. So far, I've been really impressed with the difference between a nuc and a package, and I'm feeling really optimistic about the upcoming season. After carefully scanning for the queen again, I still don't see her, so I'll go ahead and add this frame as well. Finally, I grab the fifth and last frame from the nuc. This frame is much heavier again, and on one side I see a lot of capped honey, while the other has a lot of uncapped nectar. It's unlikely for the queen to be on this frame, but of course I do a quick once over. I don't spot her, but that's okay. I'll put this frame into the hive as well, and we're almost done with the nuc installation. I've still got a couple of small balls of bees in the body of the nuc, and I look for the queen for a moment there. I don't see her, so I'll go ahead and knock those bees into the hive as well. Welcome to your new home, bees. For the astute among you, you might have noticed that I only have 9 frames in this 10-frame nuc. That's because I wanted to leave plenty of room to work the frames in without squishing bees when I put the last frame in. So now I just push the frames tightly together to make room, and I'll add the last frame to the end. Now all that's left is to put the hive back together. I'll start by placing the top board back on the hive, being careful not to squish any bees. And lastly, I'll put the cover back onto the hive. And just like that, this nuc has been successfully installed. If you enjoyed this video or you want to see more like it, please consider subscribing, hitting the like button, or leaving a comment down below. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.